Let's talk about your car. It's screaming, wash me, please. Now, if you're a Mr. Common Sense, you won't believe me when I tell you that I've got an envelope that'll clean your car while you're driving at home to work. Well, George, believe me, this time, because this one isn't like the Austrian self-sharpening razors. No, friends, no overheating like with the tropical fishes. No zizzing and dripping like with the dike.
I don't want it anymore, Dr. Gunderson.
Don't want what, child?
My coffee. The warden says he's tired of my coffee.
Well, it's been pretty clear that your coffee don't got zest appeal.
Zest appeal? What's that?
I don't know.
Oh.
That's the secret ingredient in Erzot Brothers coffee. Yeah, look here.
Huh?
A blend of the finest Brazilian soya beans, Chilean chicory nuts, and Spanish fly.
Oh.
Here, take this can home with you, Katie.
The next morning...
More coffee, Warden.
Oh, I think I've had enough.
Oh.
Erzot Brothers coffee, the real one. Look for the can in the plain brown can.
I'd in any way want to put myself into a confrontatory position, either with the United Snakes or with them. And you can believe me, because I never lie, and I'm always right. So wake up and take a look at your only logical choice. Me, George Tirebiter.
Paid for by the Tirebiter for Political Solutions Committee, Sector R.
This is you, TV. For you, the viewer.
The Howl of the Wolf movie. Presenting honest stories of working people as told by rich Hollywood stars.
This morning's wacky feature, Porgy and Mudhead in High School Madness, with Dave Kasman as Porgy and Joe Bertman as Mudhead.
He's a spy and a girl delighter. Porgy, firefighter, he's a student like you. If you're looking for a captain of the ring ball team, you can bet he won't be there. You'll find him popping off at Pop's sodium shop to trim a red with red hair. Doobie-doo-wah, Porgy, firefighter. Just a student like you.
Like me?
Just a student like you.
Stop singing and finish your homework.
Just a student like you.
Adolf, come and get it. Your clam cakes are getting damp.
10-4, Eleanor.
Whew! Defoliating in Victory Garden certainly works up an appetite.
You sit down, Father, and dig right in.
That's right. This afternoon, I'll be able to start digging the pit. If I can get some work out of that boy of yours, I can have the bunker finished by election day. Where is Porgy, anyway?
He's up in his room, helping Porcelain make the bed.
Oh, Porgy! Oh, my!
Porgy! Porgy, tell
you about it! He's coming, Mother!
He's so good with the servants, Fred.
Stop calling me Fred. My name's Adolf.
Oh, bombs away, Dad. Morning, Mom.
Morning, son.
Oh, hot dog! Groat cakes again. Heavy on the 30 weight, Mom.
Don't eat with your hands, son. Use your entrenching tool.
Aw, gee, Dad, I'm just trying to save time. It isn't every day a guy graduates from high school.
How many times have I heard that before?
Well, you boys fight it out among yourselves.
Okay, Mother.
Look at the time. I've got to dress for my bridge club.
But, gee, Mom, isn't that bridge built yet?
No, son. And it won't be until free hands on both sides of the big ditch can press the same button at the same time.
Okay, Dad, I give. Oh, boy, can I eat my breakfast now?
Only if you stay out of trouble, boy. Your shenanigans could cost me this election.
Oh, come on, Dad. No Irishman can stop you from getting to be dog killer this time. You're a natural.
Don't wolf your food.
Oh, there's Mudhead. Graduation, here I come. So long, Dad. Keep flying.
Oh, that son of mine.
He's not your son, Fred.
Stop talking.
torturing me, Ethel.